fact, when I moved here from Minneapolis, gosh, it's been about 8 years ago, I was at an industry, actually it was a meeting at Walmart, and my a woman from a competitive company, her name was Lori Brown, actually handed me her card. She goes, "I'm with a network of executive women, and I think you should think about joining us." And I was pretty impressed that somebody from a competitive that was technically my competition, would offer that to me. And then I went to another meeting, and Michelle Gleckler was there, and she handed me her card, and on the back of her card was, you know, she was involved with a network of executive women. I thought, this group, there's something to this group. So I became involved with it, and it's probably the best thing I've done here for my professional career is join that network of executive women. I have made such great connections, not only personally, but professionally. They've gotten me through situations that I've got a circle of trust that I can work through. And I've also become very involved with the community. And as I've increased my involvement with NEW, I think the benefits of NEW have increased as well too. So first started as a member, then I became, I was a volunteer on onboarding, I remember this. I was actually, I would go to mixers and introduce myself to new people and give them name tags and make sure that they felt comfortable at the meetings. From there, I became an officer as a secretary several years there, and now I'm on the advisory board. I just can't let it go. As I progress through my career, and you have to step aside and give other women the opportunity to be officers and leaders, but now I found this opportunity to be an advisor on the team, it's something that I always want to stay connected with, and I always want to stay involved with. Not only has it given me a lot professionally, and has given me a network and a support group, I want to make sure that opportunity is available for other women and leaders in this community as well too.